Hey guys, Lekalens is here. In this video, I'll be taking apart two of these phones. One is the international smartphone and the other one is the US smartphone. Today, I'll be doing the 5G millimeter wave transplantation by switching the frame and take a risk by removing the LCD. Let's get started. Alright, so two of these phones already powered off. It's time to remove the display. This old display on international phone that I had is already broken because it's no longer want to turn on. This one is the US display and it's still working. And I'll start by removing the top of this screw, the top plastic up here. Alright, I already unscrewed them all. Now it's time to pick it up. Alright. And the next one. I'll go ahead and swap the SIM card slot. This one is the US frame. Begin to swap. I'll just let the phone camera stay in the same positions since this camera is failed that matched the item description on eBay. My screwdriver has no magnets. I'll give a little bit magnet on my screwdriver. And here we go. And after I cut it swap, it's time to install the SIM card. I'll put the SIM card on the international frame and the dual SIM card on the US frame and put it all back together. Also make sure to use the top antenna. I mean the top speaker up here. And start screw down. And the US display is still working and the display had some glitch. So I'll just go and unscrew those bottom speaker and swap the connector to see where it will go. I'll just use the minus screw. And tidy up the flexible cable. Move it to here. And please, and then plug it. It's kind of hard to see it. Alright, it finally plugged. I'll go and use the old speaker from the international phone. Alright, it's already plugged. And now the flexible connector. I heard a click sound. Now place it with the US speaker. And screw down. Alright, now I got everything screwed back down. But first, I'll be installing the US display on the international frame. I mean the international motherboard. Since the international motherboard is inside the US frame. And after that, I'll begin to turn the phone around. And start removing the back glass. And since the glue is not sticky enough, it's now can be easily removed. And you can see the inside of the frame are different. This is the international frame. This one is the US frame. So I'll be removing all of the parts from here and start transplanting the frame. I'll also be removing the top frame. I mean the top plastic. I'll go unplug the battery. And the flexible charger. And I'll begin to remove the motherboard. As you can see here, the motherboard on the international and the you can see, hold on, I'll focus mic. And you can see here the international and the US motherboard are different. You can see here the 5G millimeter wave antenna. Antenna connector. This one's missing on my international motherboard. I'll also be removing the charger port. 6 screws in total to remove those 2 charger ports. And I'll be also removing the vibration motor. And since all of this has already been done, I'll begin the transplantation. But I'll need to remove the display first, just to be safe and not to damage it. So to do the transplant, all I need to do is just remove the right frame. This one is already been removed, so it should be easy. See, it's already been removed. And already detached. And the only one thing that I do wrong, making a $300 mistake, is I accidentally poked the top right display a few weeks ago and making the main display become inoperable. So I'll go try again by practicing on the US frame, on the US display. Let's move to the next table. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is use a pry to take this plastic thing off. And also on the top. Just go make it upside down. And begin to remove the bracket. Since it's difficult, I'll just go and use the heat gun. Use the heat gun, unplug my charger for the laptop and begin. The bracket. I'll go and do it carefully and try not to damage it. And finally, the bracket is already, the plastic frame is already removed. I'll begin to do the transplant. So this is the first attempt was success and the second attempt is fail. And now this is the third attempt that I'm trying to do it again. I'll begin to use a heat gun. And use some small poker card. And I'll begin to lift the display. Leave it above and do it carefully. Be careful not to slice the display. Just like my second attempt failed. Careful. Be careful not to damage. All right, the display didn't damage. There's no crack and it's still wiggling like this. And do not overbend the display, otherwise the display will crack. And just like that. Alright, so as you can see here, this is the international frame. And this one is the US frame. I kind of forgot that the US frame has broken flexible cable that caused no internet connection. I'll just have to reopen the part again to remove the left side of the display. Doing a transplantation like this is very hard and it has a high risk. So the display can be damaged by accident. So there's no object, so it's clear. And begin to heat up the display again. Begin to pry open again. Ouch, it's hot. And now time to remove the left part of the display. Small poker card. We can do operation. Apply the heat back again. Alright, now on the right side, that's just great. The screen didn't break. Third attempt is a success. I hope it's a success and I didn't do anything wrong with it. And now I can begin to remove the sticker. Remove the tape diagonally. Alright. And I'll begin to remove the screw. It's a little bit hard since this because the screw is a little bit tight. Remove the frame. The left screw can be removed, just on the right side part. I don't know why there's something stuck in here, and I just found out it was the sticker that keeping the screw, and there must be a hidden screw in there. Yep, just found it. There's the hidden screw. And now all I need to do is just replace the flexible cable. Found it in here.
to remove those two flexible cable. And to remove those two flexible cable, I have to remove this plastic also. And I'll use the SIM ejector to press down. And remove it. After the two screws is removed. So let's and this one, this will make you confused because there are two different type of flexible cable. And if you want to know which one is for up or down, all you have to do is check the sign. Yellow sign, it says upper. Upper is for the top. And I'll go install the red bracket, the red rubber band. That's the band for water resistant. And now the lower part is down here. I think I put the cable upside down, so like this position is already correct. And that's just how it worked. I kind of forgot that we're going to do the transplant frame, the frame transplantation. So I'll put this away and we'll focus on the international frame. remove all of this. Remove all of the screws on the right. Well, usually I start like to read taking apart smartphone since I was 16 years old. And this is the international frame. Right side international frame. No 5G antenna. And now let's go. Now let's put this away and back to the US frame. Disconnect, and this is the US frame, and you can see it's just look like this, and you can see the difference on this frame. You can see the international frame doesn't have the slot for the 5G antenna, but the US frame does have the slot for the 5G antenna. So we're going to swap them. Right, focus the table. And now we're placing the international frame and screw down. I'm installing it back first with the red rubber band. So here is the part. chance for the right. I need to find the left dart. Oh. It's hard to find one. This one's for the right side. My screwdriver has no magnets, so I have to use two. So it's difficult for me to screw it down. It will be difficult until I got it. And I'll just, okay, here it is. The left side screw. I'll make sure to connect those two. I'm down to two screws. One more screws left. And it's all finished. transplant is complete. But with and now the US frame is on the right. Now the US frame on the left is still the same, but with a transplanted frame to international. Now it's time to put back the main display. Putting back the main display, the display still didn't crack. That's the good news. Fully move it a little bit to the left. I'll use the pry tool to pull it. To do is just move it to the left. I think I place it wrong. So it's quite difficult to do this. I have to move it again. This operation is really difficult. beautiful. Almost got it. Yeah, to be safe, I'll just go and remove the SIM card. Finally, the display is in perfect position. And I'll begin to put all of them back. I'll just go ahead and close it, the display. Thank you. Now the transplantation for the international frame is already finished. Now just put back all the frame. Yep, the plastic frame. I'll go ahead and unbend it. I'll go and make it all straight. And put the frame all back together. Place the pen carefully. Well, it needs a lot of focus. Because it's difficult. All right, I got it. Now the last one, the bottom one. Let's pause the video. All right, I finally got the plastic connected and place the frame again. Now place the top and the bottom. Alright, so this one's already finished. Now for the last one is this final part, the international frame with the transplantation of the US frame. I just need to screw one of one of the hinge. And begin to install the flexible cable. And then the red rubber ring. Begin to put the sticker back. Wait, hold on. I'm using some screws down here. But I know it. But after the transplantation is finished, after all things through that, I can now move the sticker back and stick it. Found another screw. Give a magnetic power. Now the screw is lost. Another screw. Alright, just like that. Back to the main table. Alright, here we are at the main table. I'll just use the temporary screw that is lost. It's not temporary. I'll just use another screw, a spare screw. This alright. So all of them already been installed. Now it's time to put. It's time to put it back in. Now I have the mini display. Now all of them is already been transplanted. Now it's time to install the bracket back. Alright, one is already in. Now the bottom one. Alright, I got it. Oh, almost. And then now I do is find the pieces to install it. I don't know where can I find. I must have to gossip or something. Oh, there it is. It's right here. So I'm just going to leave it like this. And the top frame. It's already been completed. After all of them it's finished, it's time to install the motherboard back. So I'll use the US chart. Now start putting back in. Putting back the US charger. Oh yeah. the vibration motor. I'll just go and swap the front camera with the international camera just to be safe, so I could use it. I'll use a black screw to screw down the motherboard. And now the 5G millimeter wave antenna. I just have the one here. It's right here. And here is the 5G antenna look like. You can see the 5G millimeter wave antenna. Now it's time to install it on. And the other 5G antenna. After that, there's some sticker here. I'll just go remove it. I'll install the NFC first. The top part. And now the antenna cable still look like new. I'll just go remove the sticker. And we're done. Now the last part is install the display. I'll just go and use the US display to see if it works. I'll install the bracket cover later. Now after with the motherboard swap, after the transplantation is finished, you can see. Now let's power it on. Luckily, the phone is still working. So I'll just go and put a case. This one's finished. And now this one is for the international part. Transplantation is complete. It's still able to connect to the Wi-Fi. And now now it's time to install my SIM card to see if it works. Oh yeah, my SIM card is already installed on this phone. I'll do the speed test later. This one is my new phone. This one I'll be installed the old part. The vibration motor. Three screws down. Install the motherboard on the top. Alright, I'll install the US camera in the international frame. It's already connected. Go ahead and remove the US display. Thank you. I'll go remove one screw first. Now let's give it a try. And after, let's see if the main display still works. Luckily, the main display is still working. That's a good news. I actually didn't break it. The transplantation is success. Yep. That was quite hard, but I actually did it. That's a success. I'm to put it back again. It's the plastic frame can lose so easily. I'm just going to use it, rotate the display and close. And the same thing after changing the cable, the Wi-Fi network is still turned on. I'll go check later to see what's wrong. So this should be power it off. So that's all for today, and thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. I'll be right back. It's already like almost 2 or 3 a.m. Bye. So here you go. This is the international smartphone. Temporary tape LCD suddenly turn back to normal, but only has just a line here, but the display is still working and the S Pen is also work. So this one I'll be do a factory reset after this. Now let's take off the tape. And now it's already been glued to
now I just need to remove it. Okay, so the display is already been removed. All I have to do is just clean it up. I'll put a temporary case. So I'll be selling this before the main display gets worse. Alright, this is the international smartphone that I'm going to sell it. First of all, I press volume up and down button and plug. Now install the firmware update. Install OTIN. Choose file. This one, I'll go and extract all. Wait until 100%. Alright, it's already been extract. Now download the firmware. PL. This will take a while. I'll just pause the video, cut the video. Alright, the AP is already installed. Now the CP. Now the CSC. This one I've been moved to OXM CSC. Now back to the preview, the original CSC. Alright, now let's start it. Back to Indonesia.
Here we go. So now the bar is almost full. After that, it's doing a factory reset. Almost there. Currently on user data. Now it's finished. The data has been erased. Just let's wait until it shows a welcome screen. Maybe I need to plug the cable first. And then do the wipe check. Sorry, after plug the cable, press power and volume up, now it's running. After that, clean the phone up and then put in the box and sell it.
You can see here, this one is the international smartphone that I'm going to sell it. Everything, the touchscreen is perfectly fine on just only a few lines, but I'll currently use the old display, that the international display with a broken flexible. So I'm going to sell it. And now it's 3 a.m. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel.